Hi, I'm Skylar, and welcome to Tech Edge. The world of technology has no shortage of terms that are complicated to define. But what happens when you jam two of them together? Today, we're giving you a high-level overview of edge servers, what they are, what they're for, and how they're being used. Before we dive in, subscribe to our channel to see more videos like this every week. All right, let's break it down. Let's start with the edge. When it comes to computing, the term edge often refers to an actual location. It's the place where a local network ends, its edge, and an offsite network begins. Edge computing collects and processes information from on-site sensors and devices close to where that information is being created, and helps to communicate it both on-site and off. So what about the term server? At the highest level, a server is simply a computer or system that provides resources, aggregated data, services, or programs to other computers on a network. Servers traditionally offer improved reliability, availability, and serviceability over other systems, and usually have powerful CPUs and enhanced graphics capabilities. Servers have been around for a long time, and their definition and use has continued to evolve. In essence, there are two different kinds of edge servers: content delivery network edge servers and edge compute servers. A content delivery network, or CDN edge server, provides users with versions of static content. CDN edge servers help reduce the workload on the systems and networks that hold the master versions of those resources, called origin servers, and reduce latency for users. Edge compute servers, on the other hand, provide compute resources at the edge. Like CDN servers, edge compute servers can help reduce latency, but rather than simply serving up static content, edge compute servers actually provide functionality or features like data or image processing, tabulation, or device control. It's in these applications where the power and potential of edge servers really shines. For example, in manufacturing, edge computing is being used in many different ways. A robotic arm needs to be able to react quickly should someone get too close. A production line may need to be halted if its system identifies a problem, perhaps through an attached visual inspection system. These decisions need to be made quickly in order to avoid injury or product defects. The system can't allow for the time it takes to send data to a large analytics center and have instructions sent back. A decision needs to happen now. With computing power at the edge, it can. In addition to operational efficiencies, edge servers also help conserve network bandwidth usage by doing on-site analytics and only sending relevant or necessary information for off-site storage for processing. Edge servers can trim the data fat at the source, making what's actually transmitted leaner, more efficient, and more cost-effective. In terms of what edge servers actually look like, there's no single form factor. By nature of where they're installed, edge servers are designed to fit where they're needed. Some may look like traditional server blades or rack mounts, but more and more frequently, edge servers are defined more by how they're used than what they look like. Many of our small form factor fanless computers like these are being used as edge servers in a wide range of production, security, energy management, AI, and machine learning applications. The form factor and features are dependent on what the individual project needs, but in general, edge servers have an abundance of network connectivity, storage, memory, and processing to handle whatever data is sent their way. So that's the lowdown on edge servers. Hopefully this helped answer some of your questions, but if you have more, drop them in the comments. If you enjoyed this video, give it a like, and we'd love it if you considered subscribing. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time on Tech Edge.